Welcome back. I am Rajesh, a motivational speaker and agriculture student. In this channel, you can see about modern updated knowledge of all subjects of agriculture, science, technical education, traditional culture and motivational speech, etc. In this video, we will discuss about chapter 11 of animal husbandry subject. Let's start our class. Then chapter 11 is poultry production. And then our first topic is nomenclature and breeds of fowl. And the zoological classification of fowl or poultry is first kingdom animal, phylum Chordata, class apes, order Galliformes, family Phasianidae, genus Gallus, species Domesticus, and the scientific name is Gallus domesticus. Then the second topic is types of chicken. What types of chicken? Let's describe about it. Chickens are classified into four types on the basis of their utility. And the types are egg type, meat type, double purpose, miscellaneous. The egg type is called, this breed lays big size egg and are not heavy in body weight. Meat type, these breeds lays eggs are heavy in weight. And double purpose are, these breeds lays more eggs and heavy in weight, body weight. These are ideal breed for small farmers. And the miscellaneous are game and ornament purpose. And the popular breeds are egg type. In egg type, popular breeds are Leghorn, Monarca, and Cornica. And popular characteristics are lightweight, very active. And these are the popular breeds and popular characteristics. Then the third topic is chickens, classes of chickens or fowls. What classes of chickens or fowls? Different breeds of chickens are classified into various classes depending on their origin in the different zoological geographical regions of the world. For example, Mediterranean class, Longhorn, Ancona, Mercona, English class, Cornish, Australorp, Offington, American class, Rhode Island Red, Plymouth Rock, New Hampshire, White Otter, Asiatic class, Brahma, Kartanaka, Chittagong, Cochin. And the standard class breed and varieties of chickens are in the classes at first American, second English, third Mediterranean, fourth Asiatic. And common breeds are of American are Rhode Island Red, Hampshire, Plymouth Rock. And these are the varieties and common breeds of standard breeds, first American, second English, third Mediterranean, and fourth Asiatics. And the next topic is chicken breeds and their characteristics. Chicken breeds at first American, Asiatic, Mediterranean, and American includes Plymouth Rock, Rhode Island, White Otter, New Hampshire, and Asiatic includes Brahma, Light, Parma Wolf, Mediterranean, White Leghorn, Monarca, English Astropa, Cornish White. And the characteristics are standard weight, plumage, color of skin, type of comb, color of earlobe, color of sang, color of egg, sang feared or not. These are the characteristics of chicken breeds. These are the important for exam point of view. Then the next topic is indigenous breeds of poultry. What indigenous breeds of poultry? At first, Sakini. They are specially reared in rural area of hilly region. They have a slim body, strong and energetic. The adult body weight is about 1.5 to 2 kg and they have sickle shaped feather in their tail region. They can go give up 78 eggs per year. They are highly resistant to disease. And the second is Wak Ulte. They are found in rural area of Nepal, but their numbers is declining day by day. The feather of this breed poultry is faces towards the head region, so named it Wak Ulte. It is about 1.5 to 2 kg in adult. They can give 50 to 70 eggs per year. And the third is Khante Quile. They are also found in rural area of Nepal. This is absence of feather in their neck region, thus named as Ghante Quile. It is also 1.5 to 2 kg in adult. And the next topic is formation, structure and nutritive value of eggs. Then what? Function, formation, structure and nutritive value of eggs. This is the
structure, how to formation of egg. Reading includes at first ovary, and these are its description. In the chicken, unlike mammal, only the left and the oviduct are functional, while contact lateral right ovary and oviduct usually remain as vestigial structures. At the age of maturity, ovary contains about 4,000 manitoba, and these are the description of this. And the second is oviduct, and these are also is important descriptions. The oviduct is a long coil tube that extends from ovary to the cloaca and approximately measures about 75 centimeters in length. And we discussed these topics are discussed before videos in the reproductive systems of male and female. And the third is infundibulum. Fourth is magnum. This is the new topic. Let's describe about it. Magnum, it is the longest and coiled part of the oviduct and measured about 36 to 39 centimeters in length. It is very conspicuous because it's dull white color. The thick white part of the magnum contains glandular tissue which secretes thick albumin. As the ovum moves through the magnum in a rotating motion, part of the egg stays for about 3 hours and passes to the isthmus. And isthmus and uterus are also described in the before video, and the vagina also. And the next topic is structure, composition and nutritive value of eggs. And first is the structure of an egg. This is the structure of egg. It contains albumen, yolk, cell membrane. Then let's describe about structure of an egg. At first cell membranes, third is albumen, or fourth is yolk. The yolk develops in the functional left ovary of the hens as an ovum largely during the final 10 days before release. After ovulation or release, fully developed ovum or yolk is infilled in the oviduct where a gill of the albumen or egg white is secreted to surround the yolk for a few hours. Finally, the cell membranes and the calcareous cells are deposited in the oviduct for nearly 10 hours before egg is laid. Then the first is cell. The outer protective covering of an egg is cell, which comprises about 1% of its total weight. It is mainly composed of calcium carbonate. The cell contains numerous minute pores or the entire surface, which are partially sealed by keratin. These pores allow loss of carbon dioxide and moisture from the egg. Thus, cell structures consist of three basic units. First, outer cuticle made up of keratin, middle spongy and calcareous membrane. The third is inner mammary gland. And the second part is cell membranes. The cell is attached to the cell membranes. The outer thick and inner thin membranes are usually inseparable, except at the broad end of the egg, forming an air cell. These cell membranes are a part of immune defense mechanism in the egg because of their role as an effective barrier against bacterial invasion. And the third part is albumen. The whiter albumen portion of the egg constitutes about 58% of total weight of an egg. It occurs in four layers as follows: outer thin layer, outer thick layer, inner thin layer, inner thick white or calcareous layer. And the fourth is yolk. The constitutes nearly 31% of total egg weight. It consists of following four structures from outside: vitelline membranes, concentric rings of the light and dark yolk material. And the third is latebra, cone-like portion extending to the center of the yolk. And the fourth is germinal disc located in the cone of the labia. And then the second topic is nutritive value of egg. Nutritive value of egg. An egg contains about 6 grams of protein. Egg protein is in such a high quality that its biological value has been taken to the 10 NEDX as the standard for evaluating the biological value of the other foods protein. All the essential amino acids required in the human diet are present in egg protein. And egg also provides 5 to 6 grams of easily digestible fat, wherein the portion of the most desired unsaturated fat is especially oleic acid is more as compared to the most other livestock products. Egg is an important source of fat-soluble vitamins. Egg and water-soluble vitamins of B-complex group, however, it does not contain vitamin C. and the nutritive value of edible portion of an egg is this table component whole albumin yolk, weight, water percentage, food energy in calorie, protein in gram, fat, total lipids in gram, total saturated fatty acid, total unsaturated fatty acid, oleic leonic in grams, cholesterol in milligrams, carbohydrate in gram, fiber in gram, ASH in gram, calcium in milligram, iron in milligram, and this is magnesium, phosphorus, potassium, sodium, vitamin, choline in stool, iron in milligram, and the riboflavin, thiamine, and ascorbic acid, vitamin A, B, C, iron also in milligram. And then this next topic is hatching eggs and management of incubator. And it includes natural and artificial breedings, brooders, incubation method. They are classified into two following methods. First, natural incubation method. It is also called brooding and is used to incubate eggs. And the second is artificial incubation method. Incubator machine is used in this incubating eggs. Then the first topic is natural incubation method. This is most used for backward poultry keeping in village. Broody hen is selected for incubation during incubation of the egg. Broody hen along with eggs should be housed as a comfortable and protected place by providing a nest made up of bamboo basket and wooden box, bedded with clean agar, dry manure grass or chopped straw or hay. About 10 to 12 eggs can be incubated under medium-sized broody hen. She should taken out for 2 to 3 times in a day for voiding out her dropping, feeding, watering, etc. And the second is artificial incubation method. In this system, the condition of incubating eggs are fully filled by machines called incubator. And the advantage of artificial incubation are at first, large number of eggs can be incubated to meet high commercial demands of eggs. Next, incubation can be practiced throughout the years. Next, the disease risk of transfer from a hen to chicks is stimulated because there is no contact of hen with eggs. Next, the factors essential for incubation can be prepared to get maximum hatchability with high quality hygiene care to minimize chances of infection. Next, automation of incubator saves a lot of labor. Next, factor affecting fertility. Fertility means fertilization of eggs by union of sperm with ovum, which usually takes place in infant embryo within 15 minutes of ovulation. These following factors adversely affect the fertility. At first, less fertility is common in heavy breeds compared to the light breeds, which may be due to poor mating ability, physical incompatibility, etc. And the second is the semen volume, sperm concentration, and the number of successful mating also alter fertility and its descriptions. And the third is success is also important to attain desired fertility. The optimum rate is 1:10:12 and in layers and 1:8 in boilers. The fourth is fertility is usually higher in younger birds than older ones. Fertility reduces in males after first breeding season, and same is true in case of males after first laying egg cycles. Fifth is good laying flocks generally exhibit better fertility than poor laying flocks. Sixth, excessive high to low temperature reduces fertility due to poor mating frequency due to inactiveness of body. Seventh is some vitamins and minerals deficiencies like vitamin A, potassic acid, E, biotin, and minerals like calcium, potassium, sodium, magnesium, zinc add in lower fertility. And the next topic is factors affecting hatchability. The hatchability is defined as the number of eggs produced from hatch. It is measured in two forms, with hatchability on total number of eggs set and hatchability on fertilized eggs. Hatchability is expressed in terms of percentage flowing factors affect hatchability adversely. First, hatchability differs from breed to breed, extensively rural. Next, hatchability is second is hatchability is reduced with increase in inbreeding coefficient while outbreeding improves. Third, management and nutrition status, especially minerals and vitamins, affect hatchability. Four, to high and very low temperature in breeds house also lower hatchability. Five, hatchability is higher in eggs from younger flocks and vice versa. Six, eggs having abnormal shape to small or extra large eggs in See, thin sealed and eggs with poor internal quality too do not hatch well. 7. Faulty pre-incubation storage condition of for eggs reduces the agility. 8. Abrupt and frequent changes of temperature and humidity in the incubator affect the agility. 9. Desired level of oxygen and CO2 gas in incubator play a major role in obtaining optimum agility. 10. Setting of egg with narrow end up layer down the agility. And 11 is inadequate and faulty turning during incubation lower the agility. And the next topic is management of chicks in brooder. Management of chicks in brooder. And this is the description of management chicks in brooder. Let's describe about it. If you're housing new batch of the chicks in brooding house, a house, it should be properly prepared to receive chicks. It should be properly cleaned and disinfected. First of all manure should be removed with a scraping, then clean wash the house with a scrubbing of floor. It should be washed with mild disinfect under pressure. The house should be also sprayed with disinfectants and insecticides like Malathion to kill ticks and mites. Blow lamping of house with flame gun or blower should be done to kill spore or spores forming organism efficiently. The equipment like brooders, waterers, feeders, etc. should also be cleaned and disinfected well in advance before housing. Thereafter, the house should be kept empty for minimum 8 to 10 days to break life cycle of organism naturally. Before housing of chicks, spread the litters on floors, airings, waterers, feeders, etc. Start heating the brood room 24 hours before arrival of chicks. It includes brooding management, and this is its description. And the description is not very much important. And this important for knowledge, and this it includes space, temperature, ventilation, litter, chicken guard, feeding and watering, and health care. And these questions are also asked in exam, so it is also an important. And housing system, and the next topic is housing system of poultry, and this is very important for exam point of view. And the housing system poultry can be categorized into following: first, free range; second is semi-intensive; and third is intensive. And intensive is also described into two parts: first, deep litter system, and the second is cage system. And the cage system is also classified into two types: first is shared stuff cage, and the second is batter cage. The first, free range system, and this is its descriptions. This method is oldest of all, but now has been replaced by intensive system due to relative more advantage. Then the second is semi-intensive system. In this system, birds are confined to house in night, but they are also given access to runs. Generally, outside run of 16 to 24 square meter per hen is provided. Here also, there is only slight control over birds, and scientific management practices cannot be applied. And the third is intensive system. Birds are totally confined to houses for commercial production of birds. Intensive system is used. Advantage of intensive system is minimum land is required, scientific management can be employed, production function is better, saving of labor. Then it's first classified member is first deep litter system, and this is the description of deep litter system. And its advantage are the safety of birds. Birds receive nutrients like vitamin B2, vitamin B12, and animal protein factors from the litter. The litter is bad conductor of heat, so provide warmth in cold warmth. Labor serving, excellent manure is produced. Germs like salmonella are killed by heat produced by fermentative actions, control of humidity in the house. And the next is disadvantage of deep litter system. And the next is litter management. This is the description of litter management. It is not more much important, but important for exam. And also important for knowledge. And the second is cage system of rearing. And the next is advantage of cage system. Less space per bird is required, generally 1/3 space as compared to deep litter. Better flock supervision. And next is Baking and cannabis are minimized. Next is saving of labor. Next is better disease prevention, control of infection. Next, less mortality rate. Next, less infection on meditation. Next, definite feed saving up to 10 gram bird per day. Next, increase laying efficiency up to 2 to 3 legs extra per day. Next, egg eating is largely prevented in clean egg is produced. And the types of cases are stair steps and battery gates, and these descriptions are also included here. And the advantage of cage system and disadvantage of cage systems are insulin invested in higher is higher. Sometimes problems such as cage fear, fatigue may be observed in overhead bird. And the advantage and disadvantage is important. And that's our topics are finished here. If you want to take more notes and knowledge on this subject, please like and subscribe my channel for motivate me to upload more videos. If you have any doubt or problem on this subject or out of this subject, you can comment at comment box as soon as possible. I will reply. If this video is essential for other friends, then share this video and never miss to like and subscribe. Your friend Rajesh Chah.